spring chill will slowly move out, and with the summer warm, talking ticks.
Yeah, all kinds of bugs, and ticks are bad ones. They're common in Michigan. They can spread dangerous diseases like Lyme disease.
24-Hour News 8's Justin Kolar joins us in studio now with a family who knows how important it is to make sure to protect yourself.
Yeah, that's right, Teresa and Tom. May is Lyme Disease Awareness Month. And as the Nossens will tell you, the disease and the way it's spread are things you may wish you were more aware of.
Clarissa Nossen was 6 years old when she was bitten by a tick on a family trip to Wisconsin.
We have always been an outdoors family. We love hiking, and that's what we do together as a family.
Ticks live on low-lying brush and tall grasses, all areas that Adam London of the Kent County Health Department says you'd be smart to avoid.
Remember that they are in our environment now. We have seen this migration of the type of ticks that spread Lyme disease into West Michigan. They're here.
These ticks came from Connecticut, and according to Michigan Department of Natural Resources wildlife biologist Don Poppy, Ottawa and Allegan County reported the highest number of ticks in recent years.
Be aware that ticks are there, and if you feel something funny on your skin, check on it. And if you do find a tick, remove it immediately and kill it.
But Clarissa didn't feel the tick and found it lodged in her skin the next day.
I believe I called even our pediatrician, said my daughter's been bit by a tick. Should I be concerned, or what do I look for?
London says to look for a red bullseye rash to develop around the area of the bite.
It's important that if you see that bite that you call your doctor right away, because there are antibiotics that can stop the development of any Lyme disease.
But Clarissa never developed a rash.
It's pretty rare that a person would develop it without any symptoms, but it does happen.
3 years passed, and then
she began at the beginning of second grade switching around letters, which were like some like similar letters like A, B, D, Q, P.
So they called their pediatricians again, and Clarissa was diagnosed with Lyme disease.
It's very difficult to respond to that infection after it's already established in the system.
Because once the infection sets in, it becomes more and more difficult to treat long term.
There isn't a treatment at this time that's 100% effective.
We thought we were fine, and it was just a tick bite, and we were in the clear.
Now, after seeking medical treatment with little success, Clarissa's family has decided to treat her Lyme disease using alternative medicinal practices like naturopathy. And I'm told her fine motor skills and overall condition has improved. In the studio, Justin Kolar, 24-Hour News 8.